So now we want to take a look at work. And the basic idea of work is a force exerted over a distance. Force exerted over distance. Now, in most cases where we're talking about work, there will be some exceptions, but in a lot of cases, we're going to be working against gravity. And so the force, which is either going to be measured in newtons, if we're in metric, SI units, or in pounds, if we're in American units. Pounds is already a force, it's a measure of weight due to gravity, and so this is fine, we don't need to do anything with it. But if we ever have a mass to work with, mass is not a force. So if we have something like kilograms, we would need to multiply that by gravity, so that would be mass times gravity, to get the number of newtons. The value we'll typically use for gravity is 9.8 meters per second squared, and so we'd multiply 9.8 times the number of kilograms to find the newtons of force. So, for example, if I have a 3-pound block and I lift it 5 feet, the work will be force times distance. So the work here will be, there's 3 pounds of force exerted over 5 feet. The work is 15. And the units here are foot-pounds, or pound-feet, 15 foot-pounds of work done here. Likewise, if I had a, let's say, a 10 kilogram mass, and I wanted to lift it 5 meters, well, now we would need to find first the amount of force being exerted due to gravity here. So the force would be 9.8 for gravity times 10 kilograms would be 98 newtons of force. And then the work would be 98 newtons times 5 meters, which would be 495 newton meters, which are also called joules. It's a newton meter. Okay? And that's the basic idea of work.